I think that people perhaps don't quite realise, you know, the amount of effort that goes into making some of these paintings. The painting, for example, from the Emigrant Trail looking down on the San Juan River, which is a big painting, what, 4'6" by 3'. First of all, it's very, very difficult to get to where I wanted to put my tent up, which is under a cottonwood tree next to the river, because it was so ferociously hot that I just needed some shade sometime, you know, midday. And then after that, I, having pitched my tent and set myself up, I then walked up to where the Emigrant Trail took off, which is 500 feet, a 500 feet scramble up a rock slide, really. It's difficult enough for me to haul my drawing board, my aluminium tube, my paper, my stove, my water, all the things that I need during the day, 500 feet up this thing, and then sit in the baking heat every day. Sometimes the heat on the rock I was sitting on was 115 degrees. You know, you get the wind blowing, you get storms, you get insects. It's either too hot or it's too cold or it's too windy or it's... Deserts are difficult places. So this tremendous sandstorm built up and I had to lie in my tent for, I don't know, 12 hours, getting gradually covered in sand. My drawing board was lashed to trees and rocks and when the wind died down, I went back to find out what had happened, to find that my drawing board had been absolutely shredded, torn up like cardboard into about 8 different sheets and scattered across the landscape. Cabrizon Peak was merely a sort of eye catcher in the distance. And as I was painting it, 3 shots rang out. I'd never realised before that actually you could hear bullets pass, kind of part your hair. If I had any hair, it would have parted my hair. It was pretty close. And I heard them whiz, sort of fizz, 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 like that, just above my head. And I realised that somebody was shooting at me with a rifle. But I also thought, well, I'd always wondered what I would do in such a circumstance, and I've discovered what I'd do. I thought, well, I guess if he was trying to hit me, he would have. And so I just carried on with my drawing and nothing else happened. It's a fairly extreme way to make a watercolour. But for me, you know, that's something I'll never forget. You know, that's a big part of my life.